Could you explain to me who makes up the Tarpon Springs Band?
Well, it's made up by a lot of organizations. We have 7 performance ensembles that make up our organization. We have 2 wind ensembles, 2 jazz ensembles, a couple concert percussion ensembles, 2 winter guards, and then the outdoor performance ensembles that you see out there.
Yeah, so the outdoor performance ensemble, you guys just finished your finals run at Grand Nationals. I've got to ask how that feels walking off the field.
This has been a really challenging season for them, just in the regards that we're in the process of getting a new facility, which will be fantastic. But right now, the kids have no band room. They have no home. We spent our summer training over at the middle school. We moved our uniform room into a hallway there. We rehearsed. Our band camp was done in a cafeteria. Whenever it rains, we literally just go around campus and try to find a door that's open, and we sneak in a closet somewhere and continue to have sectionals. These students and their parents, the perseverance that they've shown through that without complaint has been amazing. And I'm so blessed to be a small part of that huge family that we have at the conservatory.
A lot of challenges, it seems. How have the kids kind of risen up and taken ownership of this show to make it their own?
Well, we couldn't have done it without them. There is so many risks involved in this show, and so many little subtleties that can take place that can either make or break it. And that's one of the things that we teach in our leadership classes, is just being accountable, attention to detail in those things. And those really came through. We could not have done those things without that. Just the coordination of all the elements that we have out there and the important role that they play, because they're an intricate part to everything that's out there. You know, whether it's the screens, whether it's just their performance responsibilities, whatever it is, they are the key and the front and center of everything that we do.
Very relevant, obviously.
Yes.
So I'm curious, what integrating all of these electronics, I don't know how it happens. So could you just tell me how you guys have all of these screens across the field, the trailer in the back with the electronics, even in front of the front ensemble, you got the lights going.
Right.
How does
it
all fit together?
Well, it's a arduous process. And everybody is deeply committed to it. We have some incredible parents that are right there with us, spending long hours helping us make those things happen. For the actual screens, we had parents who had to write code to make that happen. And then they actually start by an Xbox 360 controller. But if you push the wrong button, like we had in semifinals, accidentally, or something just gets bumped, that could go away. But the coordination of all those things, just starting them in the right time, having all the students do that. The back ensemble obviously creates more listening challenges for us. But we like for our sound palette to not just come from one area of the field. It allows us to really expand on that. So we have more of a 360, if you will, opportunity for different colors of sound to come from. So that's why we kind of utilize the back ensemble for some of those things, and sometimes it goes up to the front. But we try to vary it so it doesn't feel like it's the same within the production.
Could you explain to me a little bit more about that trailer in the back and what's actually happening back there?
Back in the trailer, we call it our back ensemble. We have a mixing board back there that mixes all the sound throughout the show for us. And then we have 3 synth players, 2 synths and a bass synth that takes place back there. And then we have a person who runs all the sound effects in the show. So all of that's triggered, all of that's played, all that sound effects. So we have pads back there that are played. So we have it's a really extensive program for those kids. And if that goes out, we're in big trouble, because that's really where we get all of our source of time from. And then so there's a lot of times where we have to listen back to that. And there's sometimes where we actually remove them from the ensemble, and then the time will transfer to the battery. So that happens actually several times in the program. It's just depending on what effect we want. But we try to create as much variety as possible, and the back ensemble allows us that.
So tell me a bit about the progression from show to show to show for prelims, semis, and finals, and to have that run in finals.
Well, one of the things that was very challenging for this year is, in the past, we've always had the Atlanta Regional. So we had an opportunity to get inside a dome. for us, we call it, we kind of blow up, usually in prelims, trying to figure all that out and figure out the balance and how all that relates. And obviously, it's a different listening environment for the students that they have not been used to before. So that particular performance would always kind of set us up for the years that we would come up to Indy. So we would at least have that information and be able to work with it. What was really challenging this year is we didn't have that opportunity. So coming into prelims, things are obviously completely different inside than they were outside for us. So it's actually been really challenging for all of the staff, and everybody has worked really hard to try to make it work and figure those things out. And we've had, and just an hour and a half ago, we completely changed how we were equalizing things, just to make it, just go reach for a little bit better sound, because there's so much residual sound that you get inside a dome that you don't get outside. So it really changes a lot of what that was. And I think we made some good choices tonight. It felt better to us. Now I haven't talked to the people up top, so it could be different, but on the field it did feel like those changes worked to the favor of the students tonight.
One last question. What's next for the Outdoor Performance Ensemble?
24-hour bus trip home. And then really we put it away. The thing I love about being a teacher at Tarpon Springs is it's a very well-rounded program. And the students are when they're in this, they're 100% in it. But come Monday, we have solo and ensemble, we have all county auditions, our wind ensemble's up and running, our jazz ensemble's already out and playing, the color guard will be off doing their things. And I love that about it. We try really hard to strike a balance within the program. And we really do just kind of put it away. We don't really talk about it very much until literally the night before we start what we call our icebreaker rehearsal, which is the last Saturday of the school year. And that's when we bring all the new incoming eighth graders in. And usually, Frank and I were trying to figure out what the show is that week, honestly. And then we kind of reveal, okay, this is where we're headed. And then we'll play a few excerpts from that, get everybody excited about it. Then we go into our summer training. But it won't be seen or heard from for a long time now.